in the history of aviation, some aircraft have a position of preeminence because they were the first or have been the most. The X-15 was the fastest. The Fokker 3 plane was the most maneuverable. The Antonov 225 is the largest. The Indian LCA Tejas has the undisputed position of being the most discussed on forums and social media on the internet. I would guess even more than the F-35. The reason for this is its unique story and its relevance for the Indian aerospace. Many Indians are rightly proud of the achievement of their country, and it is only natural that there is a lot of interest around it. Well, to be honest, sometimes it trespasses into a rather funny unconditional apology. Well, but that's just folklore. Anyhow, many commentators and the specialized press have argued that the Tejas has been a failure. From my point of view, it was a rather successful failure. Welcome to Millennium 7 Star, the channel that helps you make sense of military history and military technology. Please stay with me till the end, because the stuff that we discuss here is not found easily anywhere else on YouTube. This is only the first video dedicated to the Indian and Asian defense in general. While the channel mainstream content will stay focused in discussing military technology and its historical context, I have heard the Asian viewers loud and clear. And in any case, there are points of interest for everyone in the aerospace technology, so I hope this series will be enjoyable even for the general public. One final remark before starting. I know that there are some incredible experts out there who know the Tejas in the most minute details. I do expect to hear your comments and opinions in the comments below. The first requirement for an LCA surfaced in 1969, when the Indian government stated that requisite for a modern light fighter with secondary air-to-ground capabilities. The project ultimately failed because there was no availability of an indigenous engine for the plane, and the acquisition of a foreign-built unit to be built in India was ultimately unsuccessful. The main issue with this failure was that the design and engineering capability of a Hindustan aircraft began to decline, together with the capability of India to sustain a technologically advanced aerospace ecosystem. And in fact, in 1983, when the Indian Air Force made again the case for a light combat aircraft, this problem was well on the radar. The immediate requisite was to replace the aging MiG-21 fleet, but the long-term requisite was to provide India with a modern aerospace industry, independent for all the key technologies, including the crucial jet engine design and production. The initial design was conducted with the help of Dassault, and obviously the preliminary design delivered in 1988 was a delta wing aircraft. The project took a very realistic approach, planning various demonstrators, prototypes, and intermediate versions before reaching a combat-capable series-produced version. And after that point, the story has been an exciting story of delays. Technical problems compounded with political and economical problems, and basically everything conjured to push back the date of the plane becoming operational. The plane officially entered service in July 2016 with some limitation. The so-called final operation clearance, that is the final configuration of the first variant of the Tejas, was reached only in February 2019, 36 years after the start of the program. In the meanwhile, the naval version kept being developed, and in 2020 successfully managed to land and take off from the Vikramaditya aircraft carrier of the Indian Navy. Currently, a version 1A is under development, and there is a Mark II version on the table. The life of the Tejas was never easy. At some point, even the Indian Air Force did not want the plane anymore. They estimated that the operational capability was somewhere in between the Ajit and the MiG-21, well below what was necessary. The production orders have been placed well before the capabilities were demonstrated, and even for relatively simple features, like for example the refueling boom, it took a long time to have it operational. The Indian Navy in 2016 declared the naval variant hopelessly overweight, and it began a tender for the replacement, only to revert back to the Tejas in 2018. Actually, the update programs of MiG-21 and Mirage 2000 cannot be fully explained without the Tejas. They took place to avoid purchasing a new plane and leave room for the light combat aircraft. And yet, India had to acquire the Rafale as a stopgap. Which is, by the way, an interesting program. It is introducing a modern plane with excellent performances, and what matters more, it is lined with a lot of technology transfer and industrial compensations that could benefit the Tejas down the line. The current FOC version has demonstrated sufficient operational capabilities and it is reported to behave well, but the plane remains underpowered with a questionable aerodynamic configuration and a mechanically scanned small radar and a basic non-integrated electronic warfare suite. The overall picture that an objective observer could paint is that of a plane just partially mature, with issues that is slowly grinding its way up the improvement ladder with the Mark 1A, but it will likely need a radical redesign with the Mark II to make its operators completely happy. So it is a failure, is it? No. Actually, it is a success. As we mentioned before, at the beginning of the LCA program, the government had clearly stated that the long-term objective of the program was to make India self-sufficient in the aerospace defense industry. Did the Tejas reach the target? No, but it went a long, long way. Let's see how. There were five technologies identified since the beginning by the ADA, the government agency responsible for the development of the Tejas, as crucial to be mastered for the success of the program. The plane is a plastic plane. 45% of the weight and 90% of the external surface is made of composites, mostly carbon fibers. This construction helped reducing the radar cross-section, but more importantly, gave very few problems during the structural tests. Advanced test rigs had been built and used in India for the first time. The good result is probably thanks to the advanced structural simulation software that was developed for the project that turned out to be so successful to be sold to Airbus and others. So, this technology was a hit. The Tejas is an unstable aircraft, so it requires a fly-by-wire system to be safely flown by a human pilot. India developed an entirely indigenous system, which was tested in the USA on an F-16-based test rig, and it behaved correctly at the first attempt. This is a very delicate area, and the program apparently nailed it with very little difficulty. Glass cockpits and helmet-mounted sights have been the norm for at least 20 years, but in this area the Indian industry could not develop an adequate solution. Currently, the Tejas cockpit is a mixture of French and Israeli systems. However, it seems that the future versions will see more and more cockpit systems being produced in India. So in this case, at least we are getting there. This is one of the most delicate areas where improving is very difficult. The know-how is not readily available at all. Since it can literally make the difference between life and death, the design and inner working of the electronic warfare systems is a closely guarded secret. It was no surprise that the attempt to develop a completely Indian system failed, and the ADA had to shop in Israel. So we have a fail in this case, but India did not give up and it is already producing some of the components, at least for the radar, domestically. propulsion is the most difficult to acquire among the aeronautic technologies. Even the Western and Russian giants of propulsion struggle to develop innovative engines. It may well take 15 years to deliver an engine with relevant improvements over the previous generation. The idea of developing an entirely Indian advanced engine was unrealistic in the first place, and the story of the Kaveri engine actually deserves a video on its own. Here it is enough to say that it was one of the main issues that held the Tejas back, and the program had to revert to what was available on the American market. There are currently talks with the French Safran to help finish the program off and have the Kaveri finally operational. So a fail in this case, with the solution looking quite far down the line. These are the main areas, but we also have to consider that in various more niche technologies, India acquired a relevant know-how from the Tejas. One example is simulation, another one is training, where an outstanding and comprehensive computerized training system has been created, training involving the pilots and the ground personnel as well. We could go on for hours discussing the single elements of the LCA Tejas program, but I believe that at this point it is clear how, despite all the problems and the delays, the Indian aerospace industry is being built around it. And what is even more interesting is the attempt to avoid cloning the foreign solutions. India is trying to follow an entirely Indian way to modern aerospace. Despite all the problems, I would argue that the Tejas is serving its country well. So if you like this video, I'm sure you will be interested in the videos that are going to appear beside me. In the meanwhile, please like, dislike, subscribe and hit the bell so you won't miss anything. And please, if you could consider supporting the channel on Subscribestar or Patreon, that would be amazing. In the meanwhile, stay safe. Thank you very much for watching. And see you the next time.